I have instructed my patient here about the video, and to prove that I have,
I've read the numbers book, the purpose of this video, and I've signed it for consent.
On with the show.
Hello?
Yo, you have an appointment.
Okay, doc. Welcome.
All right, I'll see you.
Thank you.
I just got good news.
When performing physical exams, start off by introducing yourself, followed by an interview to gather pertinent data. Hello, Mr. Apollinar. So I understand you're here for a routine checkup.
All right.
So I'm just gonna ask you a few questions, all right? If that's okay with you. These might pertain to possible diseases, all right? Okay. So how are you feeling today?
I'm okay, Doc.
Feeling okay, that's good. Are you experiencing any pain anywhere in your chest?
No, Doc.
All right.
Not experiencing me.
Are you a smoker?
No, no.
All right. Do you drink alcohol?
Occasionally.
Occasionally. How about illicit drugs?
No, no.
Do you have a regular exercise routine?
Yes, no.
It's good, it's good. Have you had any open surgeries in the past? Okay, how about a family history of certain illnesses?
No, doctor.
All right. Do you have any allergies?
Shrimp, though.
Shrimp? Right. I assume seafood.
Yeah, seafood.
Checking the vital signs is always necessary, especially in this case, because we are assessing the heart. Checking the vital signs should always be routine in any patient. Here, I emphasize checking the pulse rate and checking the blood pressure. To start off inspection, we're going to put the patient in a supine position. We're going to be on the lookout for distensions, discolorations on the skin, or scars. A thoracotomy scar could indicate a history of cardiac surgery. Distended jugular veins could be a sign of cardiac failure or superior vena cava syndrome. Now, for palpation, first we locate, then palpate for the PMI. The point of maximal impulse should normally be at the fifth intercostal space, left midclavicular line. If it's located lower or more lateral, that could indicate cardiac dilatation. Now, we perform the Allen's test. To do the Allen's test, you have to squeeze the radial and the ulnar artery until the hand becomes pale. Then when you release, the color should come back, just like in this patient. Auscultation. We start by auscultating Erb's point. Auscultating Erb's point is nice for quick general assessments. It's located at the third intercostal space, left sternal border. All heart sounds are audible here, both pathological and physiological. There's a lot of text out there that attempts to explain S1, S2, S3, and S4 heart sounds, but really, the best way to appreciate the heart sounds is to listen to them yourself. You got the stethoscope? Good. Normal heart sounds would be S1 and S2, which sound like this. S3 comes after S2, and it sounds like this. S4 comes before S1, and it sounds like this. Now, we auscultate the heart rate, then compare it with the peripheral pulse. Then we auscultate Herb's point while palpating the carotid pulse.
We do this to correctly identify if the heart sounds are systolic or diastolic, especially when a patient is tachycardic. S1 should be synchronized with the carotid pulse.
Also, we auscultate the carotid arteries.
It's possible that murmurs might be heard here, but this patient didn't have any.
Now, we auscultate the heart's four valves.
Start by having the patient sit down and lean forward. Use the sternal angle as a landmark to locate the second intercostal space. To the right sternal border, you have your aortic valve, and to the left sternal border, you have your pulmonary valve.
To auscultate the tricuspid, ask the patient to sit normally.
Auscultate the tricuspid valve on the fourth intercostal space, right sternal border.
To auscultate the mitral valve, ask the patient to lie down in the left lateral decubitus position.
Mitral valve murmurs may be heard. They can radiate to the fifth intercostal space, left anterior axillary line.